Hello and greetings from Iceland, but today's video was yesterday going to be about the potential Grimsvotn eruption, since things looked as they were going to get serious. Or when I started to work on this text yesterday morning, but things do change from hour to hour around here. And yesterday, the aviation code was updated to code orange, meaning that an eruption could be imminent. And then, this morning, it was lowered again, with the message that the seismic unrest is so little now, it's most likely that Grímsvotn will remain calm and we will have to wait for a longer time to see an eruption up there. So, goodbye to the time-lapse that I was making about the unrest under Vatnajökull glacier yesterday, and goodbye to the text that I was also making yesterday about the risk of aviation troubles. But that's good news. But the news yesterday made me drive out of town though, where I met with some horses and an old Icelander pilot. And I was asking him to plug me to some local pilots on private planes in order to get me up to Grimsvotn with my Icon and the zoom lens. But things were getting a bit hectic yesterday after a magnitude 3.6 earthquake struck only at 100 meters depth. And shortly thereafter, we had another one in Bárðarbunga, magnitude 2.8, again telling us how close link there is between those giant volcanic systems. And I want to mention, again, that in 1996, we had the so-called Gjálp eruption. And it would change how science understood the formation of Mother Earth. Until then, it was thought that tough mountains needed millennia to form, but the eruption in Surtsey and Gjálp proved the opposite. And yet again, we saw what kind of living laboratory Iceland is for earth sciences. And in fact, an eruption under glacier makes the Geldingadalir volcano look just as interesting as a wet firecracker. So it's no wonder why me and others picked up this news and started to prepare for a huge event. But when you look at my older videos about the same subject, this looks now as the third false alarm. But then, Grímsvotn is Iceland's most active volcanic system. An eruption will occur sooner than later. And after it starts, it will take a day or two for the fire to melt the glacier above, depending on the thickness of the ice. And that's when the world will for the first time see a glacier eruption in modern 4K quality. So it's no wonder why I've been worried about how to get some footage from there. And even though it looks as the danger of eruption is over, I want to say that there is a lot of heat under there that can now be seen through a new sinkhole on the ice cap, and our scientists are looking into that now. But overall, they say that if the floods are about to trigger an eruption, there would have been way more seismic activity than we have already seen. So the official story now is that an eruption is not expected to occur after those floods. But then we have to keep in mind that one of our experts said the same thing 12 hours before the Geldingadalir eruption started. So everything is possible, of course. Never say never. But I have the feeling that we won't see anything happen for the next days at least. But there is still some seismic activity going on there, but very far from the signs that our experts know very well, which must be great news for travelers now in December, since an eruption there would for sure mean troubles. And I will keep on posting updates about this and other movements around there, since those are hectic times. And I'm very sure that the next big geological event here in Iceland is just around the corner. Judging from the widespread and unusual seismic activity all around us. But only time will tell, and with that I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.